Hello and welcome to this very special Facebook Live. We have with us Dr. Jaleel Parker. He's a senior pulmonary consultant with Leelavati Hospital. Thank you, sir, for joining us today and talking to us and helping us clear so many questions and doubts on Omicron. Sir, before we start taking the first question, we know India is in the third wave. I would like to ask you something simple. What would you tell the viewers at this point about not panicking and just following COVID protocol?
See, Ambika, the question is that why are we panicking? The reason being multifold. One is that the population at large is become very anxious because this has been going on wave after wave for the last 2 years. And number two is the patience is lost. Number three, the medical fraternity to an extent is responsible because we are not allaying their fears. On the contrary, we are increasing their fears.
Yes.
Number four, I think the print and the electronic media is also to an extent responsible. Mm-hmm. Now, let me tell you as regards to this Omicron, the third wave, which we are talking about. Mm-hmm. What are the symptoms, common symptoms that the people are expressing?
Yes, please.
It's severe sore throat. Either it is headache, it's body ache, it's malaise, fatigue, mm-hmm. and fever for 2-3 days. Now, I think this has been going on for the last 4 months.
Yes.
And slowly and steadily, it has increased. So, why should we panic? It is just like, I'm not saying that we should, overlook, blind eye to it.
Mm-hmm.
We have to be cautious and we have to see what are the trends of the treatment for this.
Yes.
So many of us can be treated at home, especially mm-hmm. the ones who are all vaccinated. And I'm sure in our country, because the vaccination has been quite robust, as compared to what it is in the European countries, in the Western world, US, UK, Germany, etc.
Yes.
Most of us have got the first dose at least.
Hmm.
And many of us have got the second dose. So when you have the second dose, etc., even if you call that there is a wave of Omicron, I think we can be treated at home.
Hmm.
It's only the debilitated, the elderly, having severe comorbidities, etc.
Hmm.
They may require hospitalization if the oxygen becomes low or the fever is not responding. But most of them, I think, are pretty good if they just take the cocktail and they go back home and they take symptomatic treatment.
Hmm.
So my advice to everybody would be that, take the symptomatic treatment of, say, Dolo 650 or something like that.
Hmm.
And if there's no fever, the sore throat is going to take
it away,
three, 4 days or so. This is the winter season. Haven't we seen common cold in the winter season? Everybody coughing, having cold, headache, body ache, etc. Yes, but at the same time, we should not take it lying down to an extent that we do not follow the norms that are needed to be followed.
Absolutely. I think it's quite a relief to hear that from you. And, it's good. But what you said rightly, we cannot take it lightly. Dr. Parker, the first question is from Rupal. She wants to know how much effort of COVID-19 Omicron variant is going to be on the children below age group of 5. How much effect?
Well, as far as the data that is available right now, because Omicron has been new, I think the effect is not so much, but yet, yes, they have started finding out cases where in US, I think they've come across children who have got Omicron. Now the year is we have to do the testing for all the patients who we suspect are Omicron, which we are not doing.
Yeah, it's not even doable, right? I mean, do you think? It's not possible. Because, and it takes a long time. Maybe by then the person is cured.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So just would like to take the next question. I think if that's answered, Rupal, sorry, we're getting a lot of questions. Okay, so the next question is Radhika wants to know, what are the precautions we should take to protect ourselves from the Omicron variant?
It's very difficult to say as to what precautions, as I said, that we should not be in clusters together.
Yes.
Try to see to it that we maintain safe distance, number one. And the other is masking. Other than that, I don't think there is anything that one can do to getting hit by Omicron.
No, it's so good to hear that. I mean, so positive. Sattu wants to know, sir, want to know, what is Omicron? Why is it more deadly? Is it more deadly? Will both the doses be helpful, from this wave? Please reply.
Well, it is not that deadly, but at the same time, it is spreading very fast.
Yes.
So you have a humongous volume that is there. And as you said, we've not found much criticality of these patients at all. Just to give those cocktails, etc., patients are getting hospitalized. But I don't think they require more than 24 hours, not even 24 hours. If you are giving them in the triage or something, you can just give them over 4 hours to 6 hours, because the whole process of procuring, going through the paperwork, etc. So it takes around 6 hours and they can go home. Mm-hmm. So the hospitalization is not there. Yes, but the volume is there. Numbers have increased. And this is why the bed occupancy has started increasing. And the fear, the anxiety is adding on to people. They don't want to go home. They want to remain in the hospital for more than 24 hours to observe, number one. Number two is, because of the treatment being quite expensive, everybody wants it to be covered under the medical insurance.
For which you have to stay longer.
So for that, you have to minimum stay for 24 hours.
Okay, so these are also things which I think we're overlooking. But again, very important points which you've pointed out here. Dr. Prakar Vipul wants to know, what is the difference of coronavirus and Omicron virus? And could you tell him a little bit about the symptoms? I think you've already mentioned the symptoms, but the difference between, I think he means Delta and Omicron.
Well, that's a mutation. Now, I don't want to get into the nitty-gritties it's of no use for everybody to understand. What you need to understand is, if you're getting, what are the symptoms and what is the treatment and what are the complications that one would expect. For that, I would leave it to the researchers who are doing that.
Okay, so the next question, I think everybody just wants to know, Dinesh is asking, there are rising cases of COVID these days. How can we protect ourselves?
It's again the repetitive question. Suppose the answer remains the same, that do social distancing to whatever extent you can. And of course, wearing of face masks.
Okay, so there's an interesting question. I'll skip a few, which are being repeated. Indian Heart is the name, on social media. Are booster doses, do you think they will be helpful to prevent the third wave?
See, the booster doses have been recommended by everybody abroad as well as over here. Mm-hmm. I think the knowledge of everybody, all the physicians, the researchers, etc., I don't think it is complete. Okay. So whatever best we can, we have to do. Now, if the booster dose is going to help you to a certain extent, if not to its fullest, why not take it? Because what other weaponry do you have? You don't have any armament with you to fight Omicron. So, whatever the form of COVID is. So why not take the booster dose? I mean, there's no harm in taking the booster dose. Otherwise, you might keep on, if your immunity is low, you will be affected in a worse way.
Before we take more viewer questions, Dr. Prakar, the government has said that there will be no mix and match for the booster dose. So something I want to ask you, do you think the decision is right considering that there is a new variant? I mean, considering Omicron?
Well, I don't know why this decision has been taken, but all over the world, they have said that mix and match, it gives you better immunity. So I really don't know.
Okay. So, I mean, it's a question mark on that from your side. Another thing which I was researching and what I found was this whole, the Molnupiravir, right? India's first COVID antiviral pill.
Yes. Yes.
About its safety, and do you think we can take it to protect ourselves from COVID? Or do we really need a doctor's prescription? So more like a prevention.
No, I think the doctor's prescription would be required, and the family practitioners can give those prescriptions. But if you're telling me how safe it is, I think it has certain side effects which one has to be really very careful about. Rather than that, the monoclonal antibody cocktail, I think, is much more safer, much more effective. So, because the dosage, if you are talking about these oral medications, is for a prolonged period of time, whereas a cocktail, you have one single shot and you're done with.
Yes, yeah, true. Thank you for pointing out that. Okay, interesting question. Dixita wants to know, what is the risk concern for diabetics and thyroid patients? Is it the same as Delta variant? So is there any relief for Omicron?
Well, there is everybody who has got comorbidities, whether it is diabetes, thyroid, you know, you have you're a patient of renal transplant on chemotherapy, etc. The risk is always there. So naturally, the effect on the human body of Omicron is much more than it would be to a normal person. So it's natural. So one has to take those precautions and one has to be very careful about it and go to the physician where they can get the appropriate treatment.
So extra precaution is needed.
Extra precaution needed. Yeah. I think they should take the booster dose. And I think if the fever persists or the cough increases or the saturation drops, I think they should go to the hospital and take the appropriate treatment. They could go in for the monoclonal antibody cocktail, or if required, then the other medications which we have used earlier in COVID, maybe then those might be helpful.
Okay. Dr. Steve Harrington wants to know, how much effect will there be on pregnant women and babies? And please tell about the safety measures to take.
Well, I'm not a gynecologist, but I have discussed with the gynecologist.
Okay.
And most of these medications are not given in the first term. They're given in the second term and third term, and they found that they are pretty safe. That's all I know. But I have not treated myself any pregnant ladies.
Okay. So
it's only with the consent of the gynecologists who are advising us. And as regards to pregnant ladies, we also take opinion of the pediatrician because they form the fulcrum of a newborn.
Yes, of course. I mean, you know, that's the base. So we're getting a lot of questions. Are children prone? The symptoms, you know, what we can do. So before that, a very interesting question, Dr. Parker, is Gaurav wants to know, how will this pandemic end given that there are new variants being reported from different countries? I think we all want to know that. When will this end?
Well, 2 years back, I said that it was the end of 22. But I think it will slowly die its own death. I don't think we should bother much. But at the same time, we should see that our health system is upgraded to whatever best we can in these trying times. By the year end, I think we should get over it. Maybe 23, 24, I don't know. But it might not be that bad as it has been in the first wave, second wave. We're seeing this wave now is not that critical. So I think slowly it will die its own death.
No, fingers crossed. And I think you've left us really, you know, so optimistic and at least feeling good because everybody's so stressed. It's whether the school's not starting or everywhere we see that. So it's good to speak with you and, you know, hear these positive things. Thank you so much, Dr. Parker.
Welcome. Thank you.